गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर रश्मि जोशी सावलकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, श्री आरएलटी कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस, अकोला। टुडे दिस इज़ द सेवेंथ लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट 3 एंड वी आर स्टार्टिंग द न्यू फाइलम, फाइलम एस्केलमिंथेस, द जनरल कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ एस्केरिस। सो लेट सी फाइलम एस्केलमिंथेस। Phylum Escalminthes was introduced by Gegenbaur in 1847. This phylum includes about 15,000 species. It is commonly called as roundworms. All the escalminths or worms are commonly called as roundworms or nematodes. The most abundant worm, which is found everywhere in the world. These worms or these roundworms or nematodes are mainly parasites, as animal and plant parasites. See, in the phylum Platyhelminths, we saw that the Platyhelminths are the endoparasites, and here in phylum Escalminthes also these animals or these species are parasites. Animal parasites or plant parasites, and also as free living form in water and soil. Now, the body cavity is derived from embryonic blastocoel and not lined with mesodermal epithelium from gut, hence called as pseudocoelomates. The Platyhelminths are acoelomates, but the Escalminthes worms are pseudocoelomates, means false coelom is present here. The body wall consists of outermost covering of soft cuticle followed by syncytial epidermis and a distinct muscle layer. The body wall consists of outermost covering. The outermost covering body wall is present of soft cuticle. The outermost covering or the cuticle is soft here, followed by syncytial epidermis. Syncytial word is new for you, and the meaning of syncytial is in every cell one nucleus is present, but a single cell which consists of one or more than one nuclei is called as syncytial. So syncytial epidermis and a distinct muscle layer is present. The pseudocoelomate worm presents typical tube within tube body plan. All cells of the body are of giant size. Alimentary canal is complete, tube-like, with terminal mouth and anus. See, in the previous phylum, that is in Platyhelminths or Fasciola Hepatica, we have studied this alimentary canal is incomplete. In Platyhelminths, we saw that mouth is present, but no anus is seen or present. But in Escalminthes, alimentary canal is complete, tube-like, and terminal mouth and anus are present. Means anterior end mouth is present and to the posterior end anus is present. So alimentary canal is complete. Mouth aperture is surrounded by horny lips. In Fasciola Hepatica, suckers were present, but in Escalminthes or Escaries, mouth aperture is surrounded by horny lips. Horny lips are present at the outermost outline of mouth aperture. Sensory structures are amphids at anterior end and phasmids at posterior end. Some sensory structures are present which are called as amphids and phasmids. Amphids are those which are present on the anterior end or beside the mouth part, and phasmids are those which are present at the posterior end and beside the anus part. Organized nerve ganglion is present around pharynx with dorsal and ventral nerve cords. See, a new character we are studying here, which was completely absent in Platyhelminths, and this is the new character that nervous system is present here. So how it is developed and which are the parts or organs of nervous system here? So organized nerve ganglion is present around pharynx with dorsal and ventral nerve cords. So nerve cord is present and ganglions are also present. Okay, Excretory tubes are the intracellular canals in H-shape form. These are rennet cells. See, our nervous system is seen in which ganglion are present and nerve cord, dorsal and ventral nerve cord is seen. Excretory system is also well developed and the intracellular canals is in H-shaped form. These are rennet cells. So, in platyhelminths, we saw the excretory cells are flame cells and here are the rennet cells. Now, sexes are separate, dioecious. We are comparing with platyhelminths. So, sexes were not separate in Fasciola hepatica or in platyhelminths. But here, sexes are separate. Male is separate and female is separate. So, male is shorter than female. The size of male is shorter than the size of female. Posterior end of male is curved. Posterior end means where the anus is present. That tail part of male is curved, always curved, with cloaca and pineal city. Cloaca is the aperture of male system and pineal city are the hook-like structures which helps in coapulation which are seen and present in the male Ascaris or male Ascalmens species. Embryonated eggs can remain in soil for longer time. After laying the eggs remains in the embryonated stage under the soil for a long time. And when the favorable conditions the eggs got hatched and the adult Ascaris hatches out. Growth of the adult body occurs typically by increasing the cell size, not the cell number. This phenomenon is called eutele. A new characters and very interesting. Growth of adult body occurs. See, always we have studied that growth of any animal took place or takes place by the division of cells. Means one cell divides into 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 16 like this. But here number of cells are not increasing but the cell size get increased. And this type of phenomenon is called as eutele. So Ascaris lubricoides or roundworm. Now come to the point that we are studying Ascaris lubricoides in phylum Ascalminthes. Okay. The earliest known parasite in human intestine is most common among the children. This is the earliest known parasite in human intestine. In most common among the children. You have listened that the child below 12 years, 10 years, always the parents used to say that krumi ho gaye hain bacche ko. So those krumis are these Ascaris or Ascaris lubricoides. These worms are there in the children. Okay, in child intestine. A monogenetic parasite. It is a monogenetic parasite. It is transmitted directly through contaminated food and water. It is a monogenetic parasite and is transmitted through contaminated food and water. The infective stage is second stage, juvenile within mammillated eggs. The infective stage is a second stage, juvenile within mammillated eggs. Before settling in intestine, it takes the path through various parts of the body, undergoing moltings and various larval stages. These all stages of development we will study in the life cycle of Ascaris. Okay, but some characters we will see here. See, the main character here is the infective stage is second stage juvenile within mammillated eggs. So second stage juvenile is the infected stage which causes infection in the intestine of human beings. Before settling in intestine, it takes the path through various parts of the body. So when the child or a human being got infected with this Ascaris, the path is the digestive tract because it enters directly with the contaminated food and water. So the main affected part is digestive system, but from that part it takes the path through various parts of the body undergoing moltings. Moltings means the developmental stage, that first larval stage converted into second into three, and third into fourth. Likewise, the stages of development are called as moltings and various larval stages. So its longest stay is in the lung for 10 days. See, when it enters through food and water, it stay there in the lungs for 10 days. Its longest stay is in the lungs for the 10 days. The eggs of Ascaris are viable for 6 years. The eggs of Ascaris are viable for 6 years. That this type of condition is called as diapaused condition. Okay. When the Ascaris lays eggs, the eggs may get diapaused for maximum 6 years. And unfavorable conditions. In unfavorable conditions, the eggs may stay or remain viable for 6 years, maximum time of 6 years. But when the favorable conditions comes, the eggs hatches and the adult worm comes out. The lifespan of Ascaris is approximately 12 months. Ascaris exhibits sexual dimorphism. It consumes a very good amount of nutrient, causing nutritional deficiency, anemia, respiratory problem, and abscesses with multiple symptoms called ascariasis. The disease caused by Ascaris is ascariasis. Okay. And what are the symptoms? So, as it is an intestinal endoparasite in human body, it consumes a fairly good amount of nutrition from human intestine, causing nutritional deficiency. So first symptom is nutritional deficiency, then the person becomes anemic, then the person shows respiratory problems and abscesses with multiple symptoms called ascariasis. See here the diagram. The left one is male Ascaris, whose the posterior part is curved here, and the opening is cloacal aperture, and beside this cloacal aperture, pineal cti are present. So this curved tail part and the presence of pineal cti differentiates the male from the female Ascaris. And this is the female Ascaris, which is large in size as compared to the male Ascaris. The tail is not curved and straight, and here cloacal aperture is not seen, only anus is seen. Habit and habitat of Ascaris lubricoides. Ascaris lubricoides is an endoparasite in the small intestine of man, lying freely in the lumen. It has been living in man from time immemorial. It is cosmopolitan in distribution. Again, cosmopolitan means through worldwide it is distributed. It is found more commonly in children than in adults. Sometimes it migrates from intestine to stomach and comes out through the mouth or nostrils of the host. As many as 1,000 to 5,000 adult worms may inhabit a single host. In a single human being or intestinal part, as many as 1,000 to 5,000 adult worms may inhabit. Mode of nutrition is holozoic. As it feeds on hosts partly digested food by sucking action of its pharynx, it produces anti-enzymes to protect itself from the action of the host enzyme. Sexual dimorphism is well distinct. Only sexual reproduction takes place. Asexual reproduction does not occur. Life cycle is simple and monogenetic. No secondary host is present. Life cycle is simple and monogenetic. No secondary host is present. So, today we studied, or I taught you the phylum Ascalminthes, its general characteristics and general characteristics of Ascaris. So friends, do revise the chapter, and we will meet soon in the next chapter of Ascaris, external features of Ascaris lubricoides. Thank you. Thank you once again.